I want you out of my seat.
When you leave town and neglect your duties, Jake, you never know what might happen.
Why are you shouting?
Look at you. When she parked her backside on my seat, she's packed up all of my stuff in cartons.
I'm simply righting a wrong. Jake should never have been allowed to be in the first place.
I've got the title. I get the digs.
That's right, and you don't deserve
it. Mr. Nick, if it wasn't for me, we'd be auctioning off this desk and every other tasteful piece in this room.
Okay, would you two please stop? Now, Iris, this office was empty when Mom resigned.
Oh, that's right. Of course you must take
it. So you better move before I really lose my temper.
Excuse me, has anyone heard from Ian?
Oh,
Ian? No, why? When I was in New York, I got a message to contact him as soon as possible, and that's why I came back to Bay City.
Contact him? I'm sorry, I thought he was still in prison.
Well, I don't know. I called the warden, his probation officer, everyone I could think of, but nobody seems to be able to give me an answer. I don't even know if he's been released.
Well, maybe the king of the jungle took a swing at another guard.
When did you speak to him? I didn't. It was a message. Were you sure that it was Ian who called you?
I wasn't. Why didn't I think about this sooner?
What?
That urgent bulletin had nothing to do with Jungle Jim. It was about getting you and me as far away from Manhattan and Rachel as possible. I'll catch you later, all right?
Now, please, Loretta. It's crucial that Rachel not see the art section in the Times today.
I don't like keeping things from her, Carl.
Neither do I, dear lady.
And you got your nerve stopping delivery of my paper. Almost froze my toes off buying one.
I'll try and make it up, Gigi.
Well, I saw the ad you're so worried about. Now, who are John and Kelsey, and what do they need her for?
Well, they don't. They're just using friends as bait.
Well, if her family's that desperate, shouldn't she make up her own mind about going home?
Can a mother ever say no? I mean, she'd draw blood for them. She already has. But she's not going to do it again.
I don't know, Carl.
Loretta, do as I do. Think of her.
Goodbye, Carl.
Goodbye, dear heart.
Mr. Hutchins, I have the information you requested.
You know, I didn't tell you, Ito, that this document supposedly sat in a graveyard for nearly 30 years.
It is authentic.
Yes, I thought so.
They verified Mac Corey's signature.
The saints are still looking after Mackenzie Corey.
Good morning. Have you seen the paper? There's an article in the Arc section I wanted to read this morning. Is this it? No, that's yesterday.
Lisa looked a lot better this morning.
It's amazing, isn't it? Kids bounce back so fast.
About you? I saw your light on last night before I crashed. It was pretty late.
Oh, were you studying?
Yes. Mm. What were you doing? Catching up on worrying?
You know, today's paper said that they're still looking for this witness who has information about this man's murder.
That raped this guy? Kyle something?
Yeah. Tomas?
Yes?
I'm the witness.
What?
I saw Kyle with someone that night.
I just wish we'd hear from Lorna.
Oh, it's a good thing she stays away. Felicia seeing me in jail would just push more buttons.
That's not going to happen. We have solid alibis.
We'll see, won't we? They've got Lorna's gun with my fingerprints on it.
But my fingerprints are on that gun, too.
But the gun was found in a drug bust. Now, my fingerprints are all over that murder weapon. That's enough to arrest.
No, they can't do that. That's not fair, Victor.
You're right. But I still have to leave Bay City.
So, what's for breakfast?
Morning.
What a coincidence this is. You're just the person I wanted to see.
I am?
Yeah, El surprise.
Here.
I'm sorry this is so last minute, but I've sort of been busy, with one thing after another.
Oh, this is, cool. It's a baby shower for Frankie.
You're throwing it now?
Yeah, I mean, why not? She's due any minute. And I'm going to need all of your help. If I'm going to pull it off, you know, before Frankie's vibes kick in.
It's a secret.
Oh, Felicia's very good at keeping secrets, or don't you know that by now, Victor?
Listen, I could use all of you to give me a hand. I mean, Ryan, you're Frankie's best friend. I mean, after Cass, of course.
Well, and me, of course.
And you?
Yeah, you know, we're in love. I'm Ryan's best friend.
Yes.
Remember?
Of course.
So, Felicia, what can we do for you?
Well, I mean, you really do have the time to do this?
Well, we just dropped Stephen off at his playgroup, so that means Vicky has all day.
Ryan?
Well, then, here, if you would. You know, I didn't have time to mail them. It's a little late now.
Oh, okay. Let's see. Anyone I hate? Brett. Oh, goody, goody. And Amanda. Mm-hmm. Alina? Oh, Iris. What a crowd.
Does that mean you'll do it?
Yeah, what the hey. Nothing is too good for Ryan's pal.
Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm. I'm just doing it because I love you. And I don't actually dislike Frankie.
Oh, how sweet, Vicky. And who knows, maybe somebody will be giving you one of these soon.
Well, I hope so. You know how much I love to get presents. As a matter of fact, I was thinking, maybe I would go over to Ricci's and register after I do my good deed.
Well, that wouldn't be such a bad idea, especially since I'm going to be involved with the investigation all day long.
Oh, you will?
Yes. And no, you cannot be a fly on the wall.
Rats, I'm trying to write an article about police work, and I can't do it if all I get are scraps.
You're researching Ryan?
Well, Felicia, he is the best.
Yeah. So, Ryan, are you here to see Felicia or me?
Omelets. Oh, we came here for omelets.
Oh, well then, why don't I get you a table, all right?
Oh, no, thank you. I'm sure we can find one all on our own. Thank you.
Have a good breakfast.
See what I mean?
Everyone is acting so weird. I mean, Felicia has never said that much to me, ever.
Yeah. These people are my friends. I'm worried about them. I mean, their lives are just falling right apart.
Yeah, I know, but what can you do about it?
I don't know. Solve this case.
I know how much you want this to be over with.
In the worst way. Hopefully, this is good news.
You can't leave town, Victor.
All I can think about is Lorna alone somewhere, hurting.
Honey, if you leave, don't you understand? You'll look guilty.
Look, don't you get it? I'm screwed no matter what. Now I need to find Lorna. Now you stick to Judy, okay?
Okay. Okay, listen. Take care of yourself, all right, please?
Now don't make a big fuss when I leave or else Ryan will get suspicious.
Okay.
Victor. You have any plans for the day?
Yeah, I do.
Well, cancel. I need you down at headquarters.
Right. So what about your breakfast?
Oh, that's my appetite.
It is the weirdest thing. The paper didn't come today. It's the weirdest thing.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll go to the corner and get another one.
Wait. Waste good money? I won't hear of that.
It's only 50 cents.
It's the principle of the thing.
It's okay. I was just listening to public radio, and they were quoting an article in the art section. I really wanted to read it.
Wait.
Do you want me to pick you up some?
No. Oh, God. You know, my mind is in the clouds. I'm sorry. The paper did come today, and I used it to polish mirrors.
It's all right. It's your paper.
Well, but hang on. I mean, the art section may still be good.
Are you all right?
Yeah. Oh, I'm just fine. I'm just, little recipe here that I want to try. Here, is that what you're looking for?
Yeah. Great, thanks.
Oh. Are you surprised at the validation of the paper? What, Ito, is the next step? Do I make a pyre out of this? And watch the past disappear in flame? Do I pretend this never existed? Or do I let the world know of my discovery? You have reached the turning point. The time of darkness is past. Thunder is within the earth. It furthers one to have somewhere to go.
Are you worried they'll discover the document is missing?
No, I don't think Paulina even knows that it exists. Even if she did, she would raise the rafters. It's time to think. Time to bathe.
I will see you are not disturbed.
Ito, my man, what it is.
Good morning, Mr. McKinnon.
Carl around?
He is meditating. Perhaps if you returned later.
No, no can do. You're gonna have to nuke the incense. Carl and I have business. Well, I don't have all day.
I will inform Mr. Hutchins of your presence.
How rude. Can I help you find something?
Iris to overhear. I am really worried about Ian.
Well, he does have that temper.
He was due to be let out of maximum security, but that was only with good behavior.
Well, honey, you would have heard something if there was another problem.
Amanda, that message was the first word I've heard from him. If he blew his stack at the wrong person, he could be locked up for a long time.
Look, don't assume the worst.
I can't help it. I know what jail does to him. Every atom is wired.
Sounds very promising, Edward. Look, I tell you what about if the advertising director calls your rep this afternoon? Not at all. My pleasure. Well, I think we have got a new back cover.
Not without mine and Jake's approval.
Now, hang on. If I remember correctly, you wanted to replace that cigarette
only ad. If it's better than this one.
Well, I think a luxury car is better, don't you?
Well, nice work, Iris.
Thank you very much. Now, what's all this about Rachel calling you?
Oh, no, I was in New York. I placed an ad in the Times asking her to contact us as soon as possible.
Well, naturally, she will.
Well, I hope so. That is, unless Carl decides to convince her not to.
Carl? Paulina, what proof have you got that Carl has been seeing Rachel?
Well, I really don't have any. But he did admit to bringing her presence back to Bay City. And there was a sketch of hers in his hotel room.
That's ridiculous. Mom would never... She would never side with Carl. I mean, no matter how desperate and lonely she was.
Amanda's right. I mean, not unless it was business.
Rachel doesn't care about business anymore.
This just doesn't make any sense.
Amanda, I didn't want to believe it either. But why else would Carl be derailing me unless he was worried that I was getting too close to Rachel?
Why don't you get off your high horse, Carl? I think that you owe me an explanation.
I?
How, pray tell? You know, I always learn so much from our little chats.
Can that's all right. The message from Ian.
Paulina, answering a mating call, but you can't really blame that on me, dear boy.
We are going to find Rachel. She is going to read the ad and call.
Get off it, Jake. I can smell it. You can't cut one who's cut it thousands. You have no great desire that Rachel be found, not while you're getting into your stride over at Corey.
Well, it's good to see that someone acknowledges my business prowess.
I see that Rachel has more savvy in her little finger than you have between your ears. And if Rachel ever returns, do you think for a moment she'll take a back seat to you and Amanda?
And so what are the two of you doing, orchestrating a takeover?
Perhaps you should reconsider this quest to find Rachel. Now, come on, admit it. All of this has just been a ploy so that you could endear yourself to Paulina.
So what?
Oh, I'm with you. I mean, love. You can make us do some very strange things. And as you said yourself, Paulina did rush straight back to Ian, right?
Well, that'll pass. She'll come back to me. As a matter of fact, I'll bet you 10,000 shares of Corey stock that I get Paulina back before you're able to cast a romantic spell on Rachel.
Are you arrogant swine? Do you wish to reconsider that?
It's good to see that a man realizes when he's beaten.
Fine. I accept your terms, Jay. 10,000 Corey shares. You remember this, because it might just shift control of Corey.
I'm not worried.
Of course not. Craft yourself. Thank you for coming.
Ito?
Yes, Pat. Mr. Hutchins.
I'm off to New York.
Alone?
Yes, yes. Do I take this with me, Ito? If I show Mac's words to Rachel, it might just be the end of it.
So, are there any shampoos you want me to do this afternoon?
Feeling a little at loose ends since Carl left?
Would you stop talking about Carl? I mean, I'm glad he's gone. He was a complication.
Yeah, love can do that.
This isn't about love. He doesn't love me, Loretta.
Well, gives a pretty good imitation.
It's all talk. It doesn't matter. What matters is what a person does.
Oh, come on now. Be fair. Carl has done some pretty sweet things for you.
It's because he's courting me. And I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about what a person does with their lives.
He lives for you.
Well, you really bought this whole thing, haven't you?
Well, he told me what he feels about you, and I think he was speaking from his heart.
How do you know?
Because I'm not a fool, Rachel.
And why are you in his corner all of a sudden?
Are you implying that I can be bought
this
by any man?
This is the way Carl operates.
Honey, I see myself in you. You know, when my first marriage ended, I thought my life was over. I thought I would never love again. Then, along came husband number two.
Just like that, huh?
Well, no, no, no. I fought him every inch of the way. And he was very romantic, just like Carl.
Yeah, well, he won you over.
Well, he changed my life. He made me see things in myself that I never knew were there. Just like Carl does for you.
Yeah, so what happened?
Well, I finally married him. We had two marvelous years. And then he died.
I'm sorry.
Oh, honey, we were lucky to have that. I mean, he taught me that life goes on. Without him, there wouldn't have been husbands number 3, 4, and 5.
Dear, too much. Oh, Rachel.
Rachel, enjoy your life. Don't toss away any chance you have for happiness. Those things are just gifts from on high.
Oh, it's hard for me to think of Carl that way.
God works in mysterious ways.
Mr. Hutchins' residence.
Is Carl there? This is Loretta.
I'm sorry, Miss Loretta. He has left for New York.
Oh, don't be sorry. Those are wonderful words to these ears.
That's everything you saw?
It was dark, but I recognized both people.
That's not very much, Kate.
But it could be enough to help the police. They're making a big deal about finding this
Look,
this
if you
witness.
Tell them what you saw, they're going to want to know everything about you.
Oh, I know.
Why you were in the dock, where do you live, who do you live with?
I know.
They might even put your picture in the paper if they feel like it.
Tomas, a man was murdered.
A man raped an innocent woman, Kate. Okay? Now, you talk to people and they're gonna find out we're staying in Bay City.
You don't know
Look,
that.
Okay? We can't afford to find out. Okay, next thing you know, we're gonna have cops in our house, Kate. Please don't say anything. We're so close.
Is that some kind of war criminal or something? Getting nowhere.
Well, it looks like Ian's made a lot of friends in prison. You sound an awful lot like Jake. You know, something is really wrong here. I'm getting stonewalled,
well,
Amanda.
You said he was going to be released. I mean, maybe it already happened.
Oh, and it's some big, bad secret? No, this is something bad.
Well, you still looking for the tropical tramp? You should probably try the hospital beds. I'm telling you, the guy's in traction.
Thank you both for all your concern.
Sorry. Hey, nice purse.
Stop needling her about Ian. I mean, come on. She's been on edge ever since my mother left.
Well, you haven't exactly been a dream date.
Yes, well, not part of the job description, Jake.
You miss Rachel?
Of course I do.
Be honest, how much?
Jake, she's my mother.
So?
Never mind. I thought we'd hear something from her by now, you know?
Well, suppose she resurfaced tomorrow. How would you feel about that?
I suppose it would depend how angry she was.
I don't know. Things are humming along here. I think if Rachel showed up, it would definitely come up the works.
I don't care about that.
You don't?
Jake, when my mother first left, I thought she was leaving just to blow off some steam. I mean, I never thought she was just going to walk away from good for good from all of us.
You really miss her, don't you?
I used to tell my mother everything. And I never would have gotten over Sam without her. I mean, sure, we argue, we fight. Nothing like this.
Do you feel guilty?
Hey, I'm not the one who left. I mean, I'm not the one who just walked out on people who love me.
I think you're kidding yourself. I don't think that you want Mommy Dearest to show up at all. You're not ready for that.
Why don't you sit down and cool off, Rodriguez?
Because Harrison is playing with my mind. Now, how long do I have to wait? Where the hell is he?
He didn't tell me.
I know he's here. He left with Ryan. I told you. Oh, Victor.
And Felicia, what the hell are you doing here? And why did you bring Judy? You two have official business with this man?
Yes, officer, we do. Ryan Harrison okayed it. We'll only need a few minutes.
Sure. I'm sick of watching this guy wear out the floor.
Thank you. We won't be long.
I'll be right outside.
Shut the door.
What are you doing lying to the cops?
I'm worried about you, Victor. So is Judy.
Look, what do you think? I'm going to shoot up in here? You worry about yourself, Felicia.
What is your agenda here, Felicia?
I just want to be supportive, that's all.
It's not working.
Would somebody please be straight with me?
Victor wants to leave town.
I thought we were going to keep that confidential.
Okay. Please stop trying to con a drunk. I have heard or told every lie known to man or woman.
Look, you tell her that this isn't about me.
It is about you. If you leave town, do you know how many people you're going to hurt? How many people that you take care of? How are they going to
feel? Look, that is my issue. Now you concentrate on yourself.
You had a slip. You know, I suspected it. I mean, you skipped meetings. You've been avoiding me. Why won't you come to meet Felicia?
I was planning to do that, Judy.
When? I mean, is something else more important?
Yes, right now.
Victor, I don't want him to throw his life away, don't you understand?
Yeah, well, there's little chance of that because the cops won't even let me take a walk outside.
Look, Victor, I hear that thing in your voice again.
Yeah, and it's called anger, and I have a perfect right to be.
Sure you do, but you have to keep your priorities very clear, and right now those drugs are calling to you.
Yeah, well, if I'm in jail, it doesn't matter whether I'm high, drunk, or sober.
Oh, will you stop that? You're not making any sense.
I know you're doing out of friendship, but I wish you would just go.
Self-pity, Victor. It's the real killer.
Goodbye, Judy.
Okay. I'm going. But I hope it's not for good, because I am going to miss you. You call me.
I'm sorry. I probably shouldn't have brought her. I was just feeling so wobbly myself.
Now, forget it.
I just wanted to do something for you.
Look, all you have to do is stick to the alibi. If Ryan can't break us on this, he can't nail us on anything.
I think we can count on Morgan, though.
Yeah, well, that's probably where Ryan is right now, trying to work Morgan over.
Yeah. Well, he decides to question me again. You're okay?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, Juan. I want you to take a real good look. Is this the man?
That's him.
Victor Rodriguez.
Juan, what the hell are you doing here?
Oh, Victor. You know this man?
He's an acquaintance.
Yeah, well, your acquaintance just told me he got his gun from you. The gun that we picked up with him and his buddies in that drive-by shooting I was telling you about, the one with your prints all over it.
You lying mother. Who set me up?
No,
who set me up?
Victor, you want me to lock you up right now?
Look, he'd sell his own mother.
Felicia, what are you doing here? Coaching?
Oh, come on, man, you actually believe what this man is telling
you? No, that's what we're gonna find out, so sit down and shut up.
Come on, sit down. Please, sit down.
I want you to listen to this.
All right, go ahead, tell him. When did Victor give you the gun? When did Victor give you the gun?
Like I told you, man, that night.
The night of the bust?
Yeah. Victor was real anxious to get rid of it.
Stop lying. I'm going to rip your face off. Now you tell them that I haven't seen you in months.
That was 2 nights after Kyle Barkley was killed. Are you going to tell me you got an alibi for that night, too?
I didn't sell him anything. I mean, the man was picked up for possession of a weapon. He saw my picture in the paper as being a suspect. He hates me, man.
All right, I think we got what we want. You can take him back. Take him back to the lockups.
What? I don't even get a lineup?
Oh, no, I wasn't planning on arresting you. But, I can change that if you want me to, Victor.
Yeah, well, I have alibis for both those times.
Let me guess. Felicia. Well, I can tell you right now, I'm going to bust that piece of fiction wide open.
Why are you being so hard on us, Ryan? It's not like...
Because I don't like being lied to. Now, I have a strong suspicion that somebody else saw the two of you that night, other than at Lorna's.
We were all at Lorna's.
Really?
Really.
Well, I'm going to find out that somebody else was able to see you that night. And when I do, you and Victor and Lorna and Morgan, your covers are going to go just like that. And let me tell you, I intend to find out.
Did anyone see you that night? I mean, that night I was driving around the neighborhood in my car and I...
We're going to talk about this, remember?
Yeah, I know.
We wouldn't talk about
it. I know all that. I just want you to know that I didn't kill Kyle. I mean, that thing with the gun, that's all bull. Now, I've gotten my hands dirty, but I don't want to do any more time, especially for a crime I didn't commit.
Peter, is somebody setting you up?
I've got a lot of unsettled scores. I mean, I have a lot of enemies.
Who?
I don't know. But that's what I intend to find out.
I know you want to do the right thing, but it's like you get authorities involved, you're going to get a mess.
No, I can't argue with that.
Is this too much for you, having me and Luis in your life? But it was
don't
tough enough.
Ever
it was
think
tough
that.
Enough when you were on your own.
It was lonely.
Yeah, but you don't have two extra mouths to feed.
This is how it is, okay? Those mouths bring me joy and make this arrangement very worthwhile.
You sure?
Jeez, don't you know how much I love you?
I know, kid. I just don't want you to feel stuck.
I don't. You pull your own weight around here, and to be honest, I would feel lost without the two of you. Now, look. I needed to tell someone what was on my mind. I did not mean to upset you.
I'm glad you talked to me about this, Kate. I mean, this is really heavy stuff, you know.
I trust you. That's why I told you what I saw. Now, you know, you've got to trust me, too. I would never do anything to hurt you or Luis. Please go to school. Please go to school while there's a little time left. Please be a kid for just a few hours. Would you do that for me? Could you, man?
Yes, Kate. I'll give my best shot.
Good. You know, I'll tell you something. Your mother would be very proud of you.
Kate, she really picked a good friend in you. I don't know what we would have done if you hadn't taken us.
If you keep talking like this, I'm going to get the tissues out. Now go.
Sorry for busting in, but honey, I am beside myself. You have any cookies?
Yes, I do. Please come in.
I'm sorry for being rude, but girl, when I feel like this, I need some sugar.
Well, all right, here you go.
Oh, you are a godsend. Mm. An angel of mercy. These are delicious.
Mm. Come on, tell me, what's going on?
Remember the friends I told you about, Felicia and Victor? Well, they are in serious trouble.
What's happened?
Some creep that Victor knew when he was using, a junkie, is trying to frame him for Kyle Barkley's murder.
Oh, no.
Victor is locked up with the cops right now.
Oh, that's terrible.
Kate, he didn't do it. I would stake my life on it. If they put him behind bars again, it could destroy him. Oh, I just wish there was something I could do, anybody could do. Mm.
have time to follow Paulina all over creation, so could you make sure that she gets that? And oh, good. Here's one for Iris, too.
Yeah, well, I'd really love to be there for Frankie, but that would mean canceling appointments. Sorry.
With Grant? Yeah, do yourself a favor. Cut him loose.
Excuse me?
Amanda, just think how it would cut your stress level in half. I mean, you would no longer have to be the perfect hostess at the end of a grueling day of work.
Where's all this concern coming from, Vicky? I mean, I thought if I got hit by a bus, you'd cheer.
Well, all right, look, I know that we haven't been exactly palsy-walsy.
Oh, well, you're developing a real gift for understatement.
Amanda, the point is, I know exactly where you're headed.
Okay, where's that?
Grant's private cesspool.
Well, that's my choice, Vicky. So thanks for dropping off the invitations.
Now, let's just talk turkey here for a minute, all right? You see, Grant is using you, Amanda. He wants custody of my child, and he thinks you're going to help him get it by making him look more wholesome.
Don't try to convince me that Grant's the devil, okay? We're friends.
Yeah, for reasons I'm not going to go into.
We share common goals.
Oh, that's right. Now, I completely forgot he hired you to be on his staff, too, didn't he?
Are you jealous, Vicky?
No, Amanda, I pity you.
Save it.
You have no idea what you're getting into.
Look, I can handle Grant. I can handle him publicly and privately.
Uh-huh, that's exactly what I thought, too. I had Washington at my feet, but the guy does not give up. He's a machine.
I've seen a very lonely and vulnerable side to Grant, actually.
Uh-huh. I'll bet you have. That's the side that never has any time for love, right? Right? Let me tell you something. He'll tell you that you're the only woman smart enough and talented enough to help him make it all the way to the top, right?
You just couldn't cut it.
The price was too high. Look, the jewels were nice, all right, and the flowers and the candlelit dinners out on the terrace, but it's too much. He never stops. I mean, by the end, he was picking out my clothes.
Well, that definitely won't be necessary in my case.
Amanda, he'd put a leash on you if he could.
You. Maybe you, not me.
Don't you get it? I'm trying to talk to you here as a woman, all right? Not as some kind of a rival. He'll pull you into his life. He'll make it so you can't even breathe.
Look, you just weren't right for him, Vicky. That doesn't mean he's poison for every other woman.
Uh-huh. You just wait.
Grant and I share the same background.
What, you mean you're both snobs?
No, I mean we feel the need to make an important contribution to this world.
Oh, unbelievable! I mean, he has already gotten to you. Let it go with the ego, honey, all right? He uses flowers as some kind of a payoff for being the perfect Stepford wife. Have you gotten yours yet?
No. Oh, this is ridiculous. Well, would you please leave?
It's still early.
Look, I have work to do.
Hey, he just came for you. I gave the guy a tip, and there was a card in it.
Here, let me read it. I'll tell you what it says. I'll tell you what it says. Dear Amanda, thank you for being by my side last night. I had no idea how empty that spot was until you filled it. Love, Grant.
Okay, it's all right. I think I understand what's going on here. I mean, you want to believe that Grant behaves just the way you do, that what he does is somehow connected to what he feels. That's wrong. You see, every move he makes is completely calculated.
That sounds right to me.
Oh, stay out of this, Jake. You hate him, too.
No, you can't have a relationship with him because there's no give and take.
Really? You took plenty from him.
You are so wrong. Look, when I was with him, everything was about him, about Grant. It still is. Now it's the baby.
Well, that's no concern to me.
Baloney. You see, you'd be the perfect wife and mother, and he needs you to prove to a judge that he can provide a stable and loving home for my child.
You know, you may not believe this, but Grant loves your baby.
No, he wants to prove he can be a better father than Spencer. He wants to play daddy. See, it's about Grant again. Once again, it's always about Grant.
Paulina found that out.
Look, he'll get you to do what he wants you to do, all right? And as long as you cooperate, Amanda, he'll be really nice, but he's always pulling the strings. Amanda! Is this registering?
You know, I feel disloyal even listening to this. Jake, why don't you take your little friend for some coffee?
Let me help you out.
Yeah, well, I'd rather work.
All
right, well, let me tell you something. If you don't believe me, I'll just give you an idea of what the next couple weeks are going to be like, all right? He'll be a real puppy in private. And in public, he'll be a real warrior. He'll take you out to dinners and to the opera. And the next thing you know, you're going to be on his private jet flying down to Washington for dinner with the big kids.
That's it.
Why? I've had it. Because it's the truth. You don't want to hear it.
If she won't leave, I will. Now, you have the prophetess of doom out of here by the time I get back. You got it? Excuse me.
What's the deal here? Why are you always shooting yourself in the foot? I mean, don't you think it would be better if Frankenstein took a bride?
No, because I would just have another set of problems then.
Vicky!
He would grant you your divorce, and then you would be able to marry Ryan.
Jake, it's not that simple.
Oh, I get it. I get it. You don't want him to be happy because you don't think he deserves it, right?
Who are we talking about here? Would this be Paulina or Grant? You see, you're the one who's into revenge, not me.
Well, have you know for your information that Paulina and I are getting along just fine. We got along just fine in New York. She misses me.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Is that why she's tearing her hair out looking for Ian? You need a reality check, my friend. Go get one.
I kept thinking that something was missing, and I never felt the true magic of Christmas before. Until now. Who is it?
Am I too late?
Oh, she's still here.
Oh, bless you. So, what are my chances? You think she'll see me?
Rachel's not one to back down, Carl, but I think she misses you.
She really thinks so?
She's acting much too cheerful, as if she's trying to convince herself that she's happy.
Yes, well, maybe there's hope then.
Look, Carl, wait. I've gone along with you, and it's been against my better judgment, but Rachel is an honest woman, and lying to her is a mistake.
Well, I haven't lied.
You kept the truth from her. What do you call that? You can't hide things from her forever. What happens when she checks in with her family and they tell her about her doctor?
Yes, I know. I've thought about it.
Hello,
Rachel.
I thought I heard your voice.
It's good to see you.
I'll give you two some privacy.
Well, I didn't think we'd see you here in New York for quite a while.
Mm-hmm. Now, Faith had other plans.
Business? Urgent? Did it go all right?
Yes, back in Bay City, all handled.
Oh. It didn't go well?
It did.
Well, then why aren't you crying?
I no longer get any enjoyment out of these commercial transactions, Rachel. Nor indeed anything else when I'm away from you.
Well, we've been over this.
Yes, we have been over this, but I am not over this. Look, we have to stop pretending. Well, I do at least. I mean, how would you feel if I were to say to you that I don't think I can live without you?
Him on circumstantial evidence.
Do I have to remind you again that a man has been shot and killed here, Felicia?
How come he can't call his lawyer?
He's well aware of that option, and to tell you the truth, I don't need you telling me about legal procedure.
Maybe you do.
Maybe you're just so desperate to pin this on somebody.
Maybe I just have to shake the woodwork in order to find this killer. Harrison.
That witness you're looking for. It's me. Whoever you are, just say something.
Calm down, Fitz. It's me.
Oh, I thought somebody was following me.
Oh, it's so good to see you, Dolph.
Oh, you too.
Just hold on a second. Wait a minute.
What?
I am mad at you. Don't you ever scare me like that again.
I'm sorry. I just didn't want anybody to find out about
this
place.
I have been going nuts trying to find you, leaving messages, asking anyone who listened if they know if you're all right.
Well, I'm fine.
Why did you send for me?
I didn't.
Jake was right. I was set up.
Elena, what are you talking about?
When I was in New York, I got a message that you needed to see me right away.
Well, it wasn't me. Somebody must have been using my name.
Carl, So it was Carl, the weasel. I dropped everything.
I'm flattered.
Are you really all right?
Now that I'm with you, life looks good again.
Wait. I don't understand any of this. Have you been released? Listen, are you on the work program again?
What? I'm asking questions, nothing.
Well, is that foreman going to come looking for
you?
That
is for me to worry about, not you. Okay?
I'll show you just how serious I am. I want you to share something with you.
About Mac?
No. No, this. Here.
I don't really want anything
more
from
you. You must at least look at it.
Tahiti.
Yes. Let's run away to Tahiti. Just like Gauguin. You and I will start a new life. We'll create a whole new life. Simple, beautiful. The two of us together.
You can't be serious.
Oh, yes, I am. Oh, yes, I am. You and I can be reborn.